Filthy pigs shouldn't be allowed to live here. Should be out bush where they belong.
Nice for some of them to go missing one by one.
What you're hearing is just some of the most recent abuse posted to social media about Indigenous kids in Kalgoorlie.
They deserve to be run over.
Thieving scum. Shoot them.
When this is your daily reality, what is it like to be one of the kids of Kalgoorlie? Kalgoorlie is a gold mining town, 6 hours drive inland from Perth in Western Australia, with a large Indigenous population and a history of racial tension.
My young daughter, she said that one of the girls said, I'm not allowed to play with you because you're black.
All this rubbish is back on Facebook again. Dirty, mongrel, black, run them over, kill them.
This tension made national headlines last year when 14-year-old Indigenous boy Elijah Doughty was run over by a car and killed while riding a motorbike in this creek bed.
The driver believed that Elijah was riding his stolen motorbike.
Protesters clashed with police and stormed the
Ten people were arrested, 11 police officers were injured.
Earlier this year, the driver was found not guilty of manslaughter. He was convicted of dangerous driving causing death with a 3-year sentence.
I'm here in Kalgoorlie a year to the day since the death of Elijah, and his family has invited me to a memorial service. After a year of anger and protests, they say that today they want peace.
When your grandfather, you don't expect to bury your grandson. Not at his age. He's turned 14. Yeah. You see all his tracks here for motorbikes, not for cars.
It's turned from a playground to...
to a murder scene.
Oh, he was one of a kind. No one could be like him. Feel lost. Doesn't feel like it used to be when he was around.
At the time of her son's death, Elijah's mother, Petrina, was in jail. She was only released just a few months ago, and since then, she's mostly kept to herself.
Yeah, I'm just starting to grieve. It hasn't really hit me yet. You can't grieve here. And probably because of all my children I've got with me, I don't like to cry in front of them. I do it behind closed doors.
Do you feel like the tension in the town has gotten better over this past year?
I reckon it's gone worse.
They're applauding what that bloke killer done to Elijah. They reckon it's good, should be more of it. They hide in the dark. That's how they get away with it.
I'm with you until 12 o'clock this morning here on Tumabulka, Original Nation Station. And of course, we
the thing with Kalgoorlie, their racism here, it just, you know, builds with each generation. Well, when I was young, I remember walking past a sign saying castrate or niggers.
Debbie says that the town has a problem with vigilantes.
Grown white men in four-wheel drives who are still chasing after our youth. It's been happening for years. One would think that they would stop, but it hasn't stopped.
I'll just chase you for no reason at all.
Joshua is just 14, the same age as his cousin Elijah Doughty at the time of his passing. He says he and many of the Indigenous boys have been chased by cars around town because some locals suspect them of stealing.
We were like jumping fences and we got away.
Were you scared?
Well, scared, yeah, to get run over. They come pretty close to you, yeah. If we fight back then, we're the ones getting arrested.
In Kalgoorlie, everyone is motorbike mad, and the Dane family are no exception.
People are just born on bikes, basically.
We
When you drive a motorbike, there's just air that just comes past you. And like, you just feel relaxed and there's no one to bother you or anything.
But in the past year, things have changed.
Some kids are like, they're just too afraid that they're going to get hit or run over.
There's too many vigilantes here, and who knows who's, you know, going to do it next. That's why I'm not going to take my chances, you know, as a mother of five, because, you know, that's the ones that they're targeting pretty much, is the young Aboriginal boys.
People in this town aren't right. They are just messed up.
After talking to the Dane family, I want to find out if the racial tension in the town is really as bad as they say.
Do you feel like it's a town where everyone gets along here? Where you think there's a lot of tension?
No, they don't get along because the Aborigines and the whites don't like each other.
With some locals in Kalgoorlie, it's kind of hard to live here with your family. You don't feel safe.
All these little kids about younger than who are going around breaking into things. Yeah. That kid that stole that motorbike. If he had been at school, the poor kid, he wouldn't have been killed.
This is the kind of town where you have to take matters into your own hands when, you know, something goes wrong.
I know neighbours have been robbed around here. A boy's got one ear open, and that says a lot for someone who has no sleep with a baby and a toddler, you know? And I'm just like, oh, I'm ready for action.
Local mum Beck Miles has started a petition to implement a curfew for every young person in Kalgoorlie.
From, you know, sundown to sunrise for school kids. I've got 154 supporters, which I thought would be into the thousands, to be very honest with you, into the thousands. I mean, it shouldn't be a white and black thing, but it is. White people are sick of getting their stuff stolen. And that's it. That's the end of the line. They're sick of getting their stuff stolen.
Surely Indigenous parents have the same fear for their kids at the moment in the town after a young boy was killed.
Well, you know, the drunk ones and the ones that are, you know, they will come stealing for a bag of goon or something, or they will punch you up for a cigarette. I don't think they care. When that Elijah thing happened, like, oh, did you also hear about the whole big truck that got stolen full of booze?
They put more value on their material possession than on a human life.
According to the CEO of the regional council, crime in Kalgoorlie isn't as bad as people say.
I don't believe the statistics would demonstrate that it is a centre for crime. And if you look at the numbers, some months they're down, some months they're up.
From reading social media, it seems like a lot of people believe that it's young Indigenous kids who are committing some of these crimes. And there's been some violent threats made towards these kids online. Are you aware of that?
Yes, and social media's got a lot to answer for. A couple of the sites in Kalgoorlie were totally out of control, and they were shut down.
He says the protest after Elijah's death shone a national spotlight on the town. But funding for some key services, like a youth drop-in centre, is yet to arrive, despite meetings with the Federal Indigenous Affairs Minister.
It's nearly a year, it's 9 or 10 months, it hasn't happened. We're disappointed, we've told him so. Indications are it will happen soon.
With no additional funding, the local police are trying to engage the kids of Kalgoorlie with programs before and after school for disadvantaged kids.
Doing parkour and playing dodge.
We see better behaviour in the kids. They sort of listen to instructions a bit easier and they're not so negative.
One of the kids here is Joshua, Elijah's cousin, who I met earlier in the week.
This is like a different kind of place.
Yeah, I like these ones.
There's good ones and there's bad ones.
I like a bacon.
Who cooks bacon better? Is it Brian or Keo?
We're definitely having a very good relation with the community now, so I think we're definitely moving forward.
Ben has a pretty positive outlook about the town.
But some believe that the Kalgoorlie police are part of the problem here.
We all know that police in this community target us. Let us as a community be tough on police and their abuse of power.
I've been invited to a community workshop. Kalgoorlie has been chosen as a trial site for a national initiative modelled on the Black Lives Matter movement.
Remember that you've got the right to say, am I under arrest or am I free to leave? The over-incarceration of Aboriginal people comes from somewhere, and over-policing is one source of that.
In Australia, Western Australia is the worst.
Yeah. Copwatch is designed to be a workshop where we talk about filming interactions with police for accountability and for justice. And so you film yourself moving back, complying with the lawful direction of the police, without stopping filming the incident.
I used to get like picked up a lot just to get searched and that there, whatever. You know? I thought that was harassment. You know? Like, why do you keep coming up to us? There's other people over there to talk to, you know?
After today, would you think more about filming when police come up?
Yeah, probably.
And then they arrested him.
They arrested him, yeah.
Some in the community have already been filming the police for a long time.
If I see the police pulling up, just pretty much get my phone out, especially if it's Aboriginal people. People just get picked up and pulled over for whatever. I don't think it would happen to white people.
I was on my motorbike. I bought it only that day. Then he like shoved me to the ground. Then the other police officer like grabbed my arm, lifted it right up. I think they thought it was stolen because the way they slammed me off it, must have thought it was stolen. Good cops and bad cops. That was the bad cops.
I requested an interview with the superintendent of the Kalgoorlie Police about some of the allegations surrounding their treatment of Indigenous kids, including excessive use of force, over-policing and harassment, but they declined to be interviewed. However, I did put some of these questions to Ben, the youth liaison officer.
Is there any reason why an Indigenous kid would have been stopped more than non-Indigenous kids in town?
Not that I can think of. From our perspective in youth policing, we stop and talk to kids all the time. But that's, once again, that's based on an engagement aspect.
How would you react if a kid was filming your interaction on the street?
Probably pose for it.
Before I leave town, there's just one more thing I want to do. And that's actually talk to the people who are threatening these kids and find out if these are just empty words online.
So I've been added to a Facebook group called Kalgoorlie Crimes Whinge and Whine. It's a closed Facebook group.
Here are the types of posts that I found on this page.
They are animals. Maybe they should be taught a lesson. Where's the justice? Maybe it's up to us.
Group of younger, darker skinned people hanging around on Hannon's. My dogs won't stop barking. Be careful.
Let the dogs out for a feed.
An Indigenous bloke robbed my flat. Effing maggot of a junkie pig. I am hunting this animal.
I found the phone number for a regular contributor to the page whose motorbikes had recently been stolen, and I called him. We spoke for a while on the phone, but he wouldn't agree to come on camera. However, in the course of our conversation, he did admit to chasing kids in the bush to get his bikes back. And he told me that if the kids were found, he thinks some Kalgoorlie justice would be in order.
On a post about someone else's bike being stolen, he wrote, "It's probably the same three little black pieces of shit that broke into my shed and stole my son's bike. They deserve to be run over," on the 8th of August.
So, 1 year on from the death of a young Indigenous boy, it does feel like this town is as divided as ever. And I can't help but wonder, is it just going to get worse?
I don't think anything can be done. It's always going to be the same here. I don't think everyone's willing to work together.
I'd like to see the white people and the black fires all come together, because, you know, racism, you know, discrimination, it doesn't get nobody anywhere in the world.
We're saving every single cent to try and get out of this town.
It's a great town to live in, but I recognise that that's not the case for everybody. You know, some people are cut out to live here and some aren't.
I think that in the future that some people get over what happened in Kalgoorlie, but it will still be in their memories. And I think it will turn out to be a good future.